Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com. In this video, you will be learning how to create new tablespace in the Oracle database in an SAP system. So let us go to SAP system. I have connected to my server using remote desktop connection. So this is my server, and just let us check which user I have logged in. Here is the user account, that is devadm. So my SAP system identifier is dev, and devadm is the default user will be created when you install SAP system, and you can check it up the SAP systems which are installed in this host using SAP management console. Just double click on that icon to know how many systems are installed here. If you expand this button, you will be able to see all the systems which are installed, that is SAP systems. Here one DEV system, DAS system, PRD system, QAS system. Out of these four systems, I have logged in as devadm user account. That means you can administer Oracle database of this particular system directly using command prompt, and you can confirm that using environment variables. Just go to advanced system settings, click on continue, and go to environment variables. Just check it up here. The Oracle DNS name is DEV, and Oracle underscore SID is DEV, and the home SAP data home is /Oracle/DEV, and SAP system name is DEV, so that all the environment variables are set for the DEV system identifier. That means when you have logged in as devadm user, all these environment variables are already set. So if you have logged in as administrator account to this host machine, you should create all these environment variables. Okay, instead of creating all the environment variables for administrator account, it is better to log in as devadm user. Just log on to Oracle from command prompt. Here just type sql /nolog, means without logging in you are connecting to sql, that is sql prompt will be displayed. The Oracle release is 10.2.0.5.0. from here you can connect to Oracle database using this command line, that is /as sys dba. It is connected to an idle instance. From here you can start the database startup. Database is mounted. Okay, the database is open. Now just right click here and click on the start button. First, before creating tablespace, I will show you how to check the tablespaces information within the SAP system. Just wait for some time to start the SAP system completely here. So if you click on refresh button here, all the work processes status should be wait, and the start column should be yes. Yes, it is almost all started. You can also wait until the color turns to green color. So before turning it to green also you can log on, at least if you see the one dialog work process comes to wait. Just double click on SAP logon icon from the desktop to log on to the SAP system. So just double click on this entry and provide the user information here. And using DBA Cockpit T code, you can view the entire status of Oracle database. And from the left navigation here, you can expand space option and expand table spaces and double click on overview to get the table space information here. And these are all the table spaces are available in this system. And this is the table space which I have created earlier. Actually, I have deleted this table space from this Oracle database. Even though it is showing here, that means the statistics are not yet updated here after deletion of the table space. So let us just double click on space overview and click on the refresh button, so that the background job will be scheduled to get the latest statistics. Click on the yes button here and the background job refresh space statistic default is collecting new statistics. It will collect new statistics. That means that table space name should not be visible here because I have already deleted that table space from this database. Okay, just have a look on job information using SM37T code. So it will show the job status, whether it is scheduled or active or completed. Just click on the execute button here and still it is released. It is already completed. Just click on refresh. It is already completed. Okay. So just let us go back here. DBACOCKPIT and expand space and expand table spaces. Click double click on overview so that the table space should not be displayed here. Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 table spaces are there. Now we are going to create new table space using BR tools. So to create table space within the Oracle database, you can use BR tools T code command prompt. So to execute BR tools and to create table space, you should first log off from the SAP system. And also you should stop the SAP system. Right click here, click on the stop button, so that the SAP system will be stopped but the Oracle database will run. So what Oracle database still open. So when it is open, then only you can create table space. Just wait until the color turns to gray. Okay, it is done. Now either you can close or you can minimize it. Okay, now just open BR tools from the command prompt. Just go to command prompt, type BRTOOLS tools, and this is the first initial screen of BR tools. From here it is called choice menu, choice menu 1. Please make a selection. And what you have to perform, that option you have to select. That is, in this case you have to select second option. Why? Because you are going to create table space in the database. That is second option you have to choose. From here just enter 2 from your keyboard and hit enter, so that next choice menu again will be displayed. That is choice menu 5. Please make a selection what you are going to perform on this database. You are going to create table space, so that again enter 2 and hit enter from the keyboard. Okay, and this is called input menu, and from this you can select your different parameters using these numbers. That is br space profile is init dev.sap, and because you have logged into the SAP system, logged into the host using dev adm user, that's why the related profile will be taken by the br tools also. So that is init dev.sap, and database user password, it is operating system user and password will be used to connect to the database, and table space name, and the table space name you want to create, that is you can provide using third option, means you choose 3 here and hit enter and provide the name, that is enter string value for table space. What is the string value you have to use? You have to follow the SAP naming conventions, that is PSAP, and the schema of the database, that is SR3 in the case of SAP NetUI systems, and the name of the table space what you want to create, Raz new. Okay, just hit enter so that the particular option will be updated with the information which you have provided here. And confirmation mode is yes, scrolling line count is 20, and language is English, and br space command line completely will be provided here, that is hyphen p, that is profile init dev.sap, and scrolling line count is 20, language is English, and hyphen f ts create, that means br space hyphen f ts create command also can be used directly from the command prompt. Okay, and hyphen t, the table space name is psap sr3 ras new, and standard keys are c continue, just type c from the keyboard and hit enter. Okay, and again the br space command completely displayed here again, and it is just informing you that br space will be started with options hyphen p init dev.sap so and so, and just you have to accept by using c from your keyboard, enter c, hit enter, and again the input menu 305 will be displayed. Menu options for creation of table space in database dev, that is the system identifier of the database, even SAP identifier is also same, that is dev only, and table space name is this, and these are all the parameters for the particular table space which will be created now. Okay, and just enter C again from this screen, and it is going to create the data file, that is space options for creation of table space. For this table space, first file will be created in this particular folder, that is c:\oracle/dev/sap.4/sr3/raz_new_1/, this is a folder, and sr3/raz_new.data1 is the file name, and this particular file name will be created inside this folder and inside SAP data 4 folder. SAP data 4 is already existing, that is you can view the data folder from here, like double click on C drive and double click on Oracle directory, double click on DEV directory, double click on SAP data 4 directory which is already there. Okay, inside this directory it is going to create the new folder called sr3/raz_new_1. Just accept the values which are all provided here by using C from your keyboard, that is C, hit enter, And next option is asking you whether you want to create second data file or not. That is, next data file can be specified now. Do you want to perform this action? Actually, it is not required now. Just simply press N from your keyboard and hit enter. That means only one data file will be created. Okay, so the control file, the data file has been already created. New table data class user2 created for table space psap sr3 ras new of owner sap sr3. And just go up. Here you entered n. The action will be skipped. And what it is saying, directory /oracle/dev/sap-reorg/ this is the file will be created as it is created. And next, the control file will be named as control.control.cntrl.dev.old will be created. And the folder will be created. This is the folder that is inside SAP data 4 SR3 RAS new underscore one created. And creating tablespace PSAP SR3 RAS new is created. It is created already. Yes, the data file also is created successfully with file so, and the file size is 20 MB. Okay, so this is the screen will be displayed again for further operation. Just enter C from your keyboard and hit enter. And so what it is showing here, execution of BR space finished with the return code 0. That means perfectly the table space has been created in this database. Okay, just again enter C from here, 2 times C, hit enter. So it will come back to the menu of, that is choice menu, database space management menu. Okay, so from here you just again, if you want to extend this table space, you can continue from here, or you can stop the table space creation from here from the screen using S stop. Okay, just enter S stop and S here, it will come out completely. Exit from this screen. Okay, now we are ready to start the SAP system using SAP Management Console to check whether the table space has been created or not. Just right click here, click on the start button, click on OK button. Just wait until it turns green. Yes, it is completely starting fastly. Just double click on SAP logon, double click on dev, and enter the user account and password in the SAP initial screen, and dbacockpit enter, and go to space here, and table spaces, double click on, or you again you may need to run the refresh. That means the background job should be scheduled to get the new statistics. Here only 7 table spaces are available. The newly created table space still not displayed here. To get the display of that particular table space, just double click on space for you, and these are all the old statistics. Just click on the refresh button to schedule the job. Okay, and this action will refresh all data sets. Would you like to continue? Yes, it is refreshing. Just click on the S button. And background job also is scheduling. That is background job refresh space statistics, default is collecting new statistics. Yes, just continue here and go to SM37 quickly to get the information about the job status. Yes, it is already completed. Okay, just see, this is the time 111, it is completed. Just go back from here and dbacockpit and go to space for you here again, space for you and table spaces, double click on for you. By this time the information about the newly created newly created table space must be displayed here. So this is the newly created table space. So in this way, you can create a new tablespace in the Oracle database in an SAP system. I hope you understood very well how to perform this particular experiment. If you have any questions on this particular experiment, you can leave your comments in my website www.punarvasi.com. Thanks for watching.